We are in a lab. Why? Because this is the kind of place where research gets done. But what happens to that research once it is done? You have your results, you have your data. What do you do with it? Well, science is based upon a cumulative effort. Scientists do work, and their results are made known to other scientists who then can build upon it. This is where publication comes into the picture, because there's no point in doing any experiment and getting results if you don't let anyone know what it is that you have done. Well, the traditional way of letting other scientists know is through what we call the peer review process. You do your experiments, you write it up, you get your data, you send it into a journal. The editor of the journal sends it out to what we call referees, who are experts in the field. And they review the publication, determine whether or not it merits being put into print, or these days, electronic print. These people are aware of who the researchers are, but the researchers do not know who the referee is. So it is sort of a blinded system, although only one way. And there's a lot of back and forth correspondence, and eventually the paper is either accepted or is rejected. Here's the issue. There are thousands and thousands and thousands of journals. Many of them, of course, extremely reputable. The New England Journal of Medicine, The Lancet. These are great journals, and they have very, very high standards for what they accept as publication. But unfortunately, these days, there are also so-called predatory journals, or pay-for-play journals, where just about anything can be published as long as you pay a fee for it. And unfortunately, many people do not understand this, that just because something is, quote, peer-reviewed, doesn't mean it's proven or reliable. If you get a paper, for example, like this, Management of Chronic Pain Using Complementary Integrative Medicine from the British Medical Journal, this is a substantial paper, and it's reliable. British Medical Journal is a very, very good publication. They have a good record of refereeing. On the other hand, when you get a paper like this, the conceptual penis as a social construct, well, immediately your eyebrows go up. And believe it or not, that paper is really a hoax paper that two researchers submitted to a journal just to see whether or not it could be published. It is total nonsense. The sentences make no sense. They use nonsensical terms. But nevertheless, it got into print because somehow it skipped by the peer review process in one of these predatory journals. So the moral of this story is that not all peer-reviewed papers are equivalent. And just because you see some comment about the data having been peer-reviewed, it doesn't mean it's trustworthy. You have to take a further look and find out just what journal this was published in and what the record of that journal is. Because disseminating information is really the key to science. As Isaac Newton said when he was asked how come he was so good and he had so many discoveries, he said, "It is because I stood on the shoulders of others." And that is what science is all about. But we have to make sure that the information that gets out there is reliable. So don't believe too much in the penis being some kind of social construct. It is something else, as you well know.